Walk this way. You lead away. All right, so we're heading up to the stage.
Now,
do you have this? Do you have?
Do you know where you're going?
This will be good. This will be good.
Do you have any pre-show rituals
for the stage? The whole crew, band, everybody comes and hangs out in the dressing room and just does a big old shot. Right, Morgan?
Yeah.
It's Morgan. Morgan, say hi.
Peace. How to get your BlackBerry hooked up.
So, oh, no. You haven't hooked up, man.
No, I haven't. He's working on his. So this is what we see. I don't do the crackberry.
For the record, he is not on a crackberry.
No, it will consume my life.
Don't send him any text messages. He won't get them. He doesn't have.
So when we walk up through the back way, this is what we see. We're looking at the back of the back of the curtain, and we pull up behind the curtain, and. We've got our ears in, and then there's a massive explosion, curtain drops, and out we come. So now, just cut to some footage of us doing that.
Massive explosion,
us running out. Then we go into animals.
Now, I'm curious, because the pyro is amazing, that wall of fire that comes out. Has there ever been a problem with the pyro?
Why would you do it, dude? Don't do it.
Keep knocking.
I'm not even going there.
I should ask me asking
just from just looking around at everybody, seeing that we all have 10 fingers.
Still have your hair?
Still, yeah.
Well, hold on. You just got a haircut.
Right? Just got a haircut. We haven't singed off anything yet. All the important parts are still with us, so we're good.
Okay. All right. So
why would you do it? It's like, I got one for you. Oh, have any of your loved ones ever been killed in a fatal car crash?
Why, in fact, no, they haven't. But thank you, Jack.
Now you know how I feel.
All right, I will bite the ball. I will go out there tonight first, and okay. I will test it for you. Okay. How's that? Just to make sure you guys are okay. I will lay down my life.
Here we go.
All right, so what's next? What else do we got back here?
Now, at this point in time, you've got three bands worth of crap up here. You've got just guitars and stuff all over the place. Now, then we've got layer and layer and layer of band. We've got four bands on the road with us right now. I think it's Hinder right now that's up front. So, as you can see, the stage is so full that these boys are like right up at the front, and there's all their gears just lined right up. So, that is the first thing everyone's going to see as soon as they walk in. They're going to see the great big the Hinder logo, then they're going to start playing some rock and roll tunes, and then it just kind of carries on from there.
Chad, when you walk out here for the first time at a new venue, doesn't matter how long you've been doing this, do you still get butterflies? Like, do you still get nervous each night?
It depends. Sometimes it's just excitement. Sometimes you just want to get out there and you want to play and you want to blow stuff up and you want to, you know, watch people sing along. Sometimes if you've gone a week or more without doing a show, you get a little nervous. You're just like, oh, I really hope I remember how all of this goes. and that's pretty much it.
And what's it like? So you stand out here, and you're facing, you know, in New Zealand, what was it, 100,000 people you were playing for with the Stones?
I think we did, one of the nights was about 45, and the other one was 50.
What's it like facing that mass of people?
After 6,000 or 7,000 people, you don't really know the difference. Some people go like, tonight's a big one. Tonight's 75. I'm like, how can you tell? How can you tell the difference? How can you even see? Because there's just this, I just refer to it as the ocean of humanity. You can't, I can't differentiate between 40 and 70,000 people. Not without a helicopter. You're just looking out over that many more people. And you don't get any more nervous. But sometimes you think to yourself, well, if we do a really bad job tonight, like, you know, if we mess up and hit a bunch of wrong chords, and if I start singing flat or sharp or whatever it might be, and you just start having a bad show, you just have a lot more people walking away going, well, that wasn't very good. And you don't want that to happen, so there might be a little bit more pressure, but...
What do you do? I mean, you put so much energy into your vocals. What do you do to keep it in shape? Let's get the secret of Chad's vocal training.
Yeah. Tequila, no sleep, and bong hits.
Coincidentally, that's what I do, and I don't even sing.
Great for the vocal cords. Yeah. I'm an idiot, actually. I don't take care of my stuff the way I should. My junk. Mm-hmm. I should really, you know, do something. I warm up. I do warm up.
How do you warm up? What do you do? Do you do vocal exercises?
Yeah, I just do some light stuff. You wouldn't run a marathon without stretching first, and it's the same sort of thing. You stretch your vocal cords, and then you do, different exercises just to get it warmed up, and then you start singing softly, some nice low stuff, and then I just move into a higher and higher range, and then before you know it, you put on the distortion pedal on the old on the vocals, and just start screaming, and it tends to just kind of keep going, I don't know. I'm just lucky that way. I've only really ran into trouble a couple of times where I was really scared that things weren't going to work inside here. But
have you ever had to cancel a show because of your voice?
Once.
Oh, once, it must kill you.
Once in 10 years. No, I was happy to cancel.
Oh, oh okay.
I was really happy to not have to sing that night. When we would do, sometimes we do, well, one year we did 220 shows. In a 365-day period, and that was, that was only a portion of the tour.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot of shows, it can be really hard on the pipes.
Well, how's this tour been different for you? I mean, you're about halfway through it, right?
Yeah, this one, it's a little more relaxed. I mean, now we've kind of got the schedule worked out so we can do, two on, one off, two on, one off. Sometimes there's a three in a row, and that makes it easier. All I really do at that point in time is just party a little bit more, I think. It's like, another day off coming up. Let's go do something. Anybody know any cool nightclubs in town? And then you grab a couple of the other bands, and then before you know it, there's like this massive entourage, and you all head down to a club and sort of infiltrate, take over.
Yes, but tell them what you did last. Tell them where you were last night from 7 till 10.
We went to a movie theater.
What did you watch?
I can't tell you that.
Superman Returns.
We did. I went and watched Superman. It was awesome.
Yeah. Now,
you haven't seen it yet. It was
I know. You don't want to spoil it.